Hi guys, it's something of a belated Halloween episode. Today I'm going to be talking about a couple of really cool parasitic plants. When talking about parasitic plants, there are a couple of terms that come in handy when describing these plants. The first pair of these are facultative and obligate. A facultative parasitic plant can complete its life cycle without its host, though it would prefer to have its host. An obligate parasite has to have its host to complete its life cycle. A second pair of terms is holoparasite and hemiparasite. Now, a holoparasite has next to no chlorophyll, meaning it's completely reliant on its host for nutrients. A hemiparasite, however, might have some chlorophyll, so it can produce some of its own nutrients, but still needs its host. Now, the first of the parasitic plants I'm going to talk about is a holoparasite, and that's the albino redwood, Sequoia sempervirens. Now, most redwoods are large, normal trees that have chlorophyll to produce their own nutrients. An albino redwood is a mutant that doesn't contain chlorophyll, which is why its leaves look like this. And because it doesn't contain chlorophyll, it can't create its own nutrients. As a solution, albino redwoods graft their root systems onto the root systems of healthy redwoods so that they can gain nutrients that way. There are only a handful of these albino redwoods known to exist, and their locations are kept secret to keep them safe. Now, a parasitic plant you might not normally think of is mistletoe. Mistletoe describes a lot of plants, but one specific example is Viscum album, European mistletoe. Mistletoe grows on the trunks of trees and absorbs its nutrients by leaching them from the tree. They would also be a heavy parasite because they do contain some chlorophyll to produce their own nutrients. Mistletoe is actually poisonous because it contains viscumin, a compound that inhibits protein synthesis in cells. Now, this last parasitic plant is a weird one. Its common name is sandfood, though its scientific name is Phyllisma sonnerae. Sandfood is a very rare flowering plant that grows in the deserts of the western US. Only the plant's inflorescence or flower is visible above the sand level, and its stem grows underground. This stem can be up to 6 feet or 2 meters long, and it reaches down through the ground to graft onto root systems of neighboring shrubs. This plant also does not have chlorophyll, as you can tell from this picture. It is not green at all. This means it is also a holoparasite like the albino redwood. Thank you for watching this quick video about parasitic plants. For more botanical content, check out www.brilliantbotany.com. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time.